Everyone, good evening. Great to see you all again for a very, very lively session on black and white. I know everybody is very, very keen to shoot black and white. And of course, they want to understand how and what to shoot with black and white is very important. Because every picture can't be like meant for black and white. You need to justify yourself that, okay, I need this picture as a black and white, maybe because of the content which needed a black and white treatment. So especially for the black and white masterclass, I'm wearing the black and then the wall is white, okay? So the feel should be there when we talk about the subject. So let me start. The topic came into my mind that, we'll talk about black and white for the sake of art or heart. So my point was, people think that, when you shoot a picture and you convert it into a black and white, so it is more towards art and it looks like a piece of art or a fine art image, which is not right now, which is not happening. For me, when I go compose a shot, for me what goes on is when I see from the viewfinder and, my heart says, okay, I need this picture in black and white because of the mood of the picture or the elements color or maybe the distraction going on, which maybe looks annoying when you shoot it in color, right? So that way I decide myself, my heart says that, this picture need to be in black and white. So I do it that way. So to tell you all, good thing about now is we can see the shots in our electronic viewfinder before shooting. So the point is when we are aiming the shot and we look from the viewfinder and we realize, okay, this black and white looks stunning in this situation, and how light is playing its important role, we can see it live happening. So it works very good. I'll show you that also how it works. So my association with black and white photography started since I was a child, because my guru, Mr. S. Paul, my dad, was already shooting black and whites in those days. During my younger days and, when I was just a kid, I was assisting my dad on his assignments with a Pentax or a Nikon film camera. And that time we were shooting film, and then that nostalgic feeling is always in the mind, like processing those films in the dark room, in a tank, and then and making enlargements at home, because we used to make our own black and white prints of whatever size. So I still remember 2 a.m. at night, and I was with my dad and he was making prints with the enlargers, 6 enlargers lined up in a room. And that time, his bedroom was one of the bedrooms was converted into a dark room, because he needed a bigger space, because to keep those 6 enlargers, Leica was one, Leica autofocus enlarger, then Dust, then LPL, Japanese. So, and Kaiser. Kaiser is, again, our German brand for enlargers. So, 6 enlargers with different lenses all in his dark room. So, that nostalgic feel I have seen from my heart, I can feel those time spent with that legendary photographer. And this is, again, one of the shot which I have been using also on this Facebook and Instagram. This is one of my oldest picture of digital medium. So that time the cameras were only 6.1 megapixel, and this was from my catalog of exhibition. So a lot of black and whites were already taken, and let me share with you, like the film was a nostalgic feeling, the texture of the film. And after publishing, when you get published, then of course you see how it works. So I will say all to my one suggestion to everyone: just get your pictures printed and see how it works, how it looks. then it makes sense. Then you can see those ideal tones. And I remember one thing in black and white photography, the monochromatic style, the very, very important is the middle tone. People think black and white is just black and white. No, that is a style of photography where the contrast is kept very high so that you eliminate middle tone. But then the grays are very, very important. I'll show you a couple of pictures and then we'll see how the gray is working in those images and how the high contrast is working in certain images. So that would be a learning experience altogether with everyone. So I'll start the mood with very first of them, like this one, right? So can you see now the picture is very, very simple and you know, it's a street style image. And I was shooting with a digital camera that time and 6.1 megapixel. And then I realized that, you know, this picture needed a black and white treatment so that you can feel the street and the politician with his white kurta pajama attire and then very, very typical. And then the sweeper on the left hand side is like sweeping the road. So this was in Delhi. And then just when I opened this picture in my system, so I just converted it into a black and white. And since then I have never seen and go back and seen that color version because you know that appealed so much. And this is one of my, you can say like most adorable picture of street since mid 2000 because it was shot somewhere in 2005. So it's 15 years of making this picture on digital. So I love playing with the pictures when I process. But then if the picture needed a color, so you can't make a black and white of that. So we'll see some more and then see one of this shot. Now, wherever you will have lines and, you know, lot of shadows and character to it and no colors are there, you feel that, you know, colors are missing in that picture, but light is very, very pretty. So I would suggest you to go with a monochromatic style and you just convert it into a black and white. So that works fantastic, right? So see this picture example, like this private talks happening on a Delhi gardens and you know, the green was overpowering the shot. So when I was visualizing through my viewfinder, I saw like the white and blacks are too good and the arrangement is very, very classy. So and it's a little offbeat also. So I made my mind that I need to eliminate this green grass from my picture anyway, because that won't give that beauty, right? So in that way, you know, I decided on the spot that, you know, this could be a color picture. So both were taken at a different places, different timings, but then the treatment was given a black and white. So I would suggest everyone to shoot raw along with black and white. You know, that make more sense because you can go back and you can process, you can keep them in color also, because all your raw pictures are essentially a digital negative, pure straight from the sensors. So you can retain those color pictures as well. And when you process them in black and white, of course you can have a black and white. So see again, see this image again. So you can imagine like the green color could be spoiling the image too much. So this would be the best thing you can think when you are shooting or you are, you know, capturing some moment, right? So, or maybe something like this, very, very, essentially a black and white subject, very, very minimalistic style of composition where, you know, less is more, you can say, not too many elements clashing, but then again, no color or just a deep green water is not making sense. So, but then the guy diving could be the main element of the pictures, and by making it black and white, you can feel that, you know, oh yeah, this is looking much better, like, you know, very, very clean and style. Yeah, you know, that everyone knows like Pushkar is known for colors and, you know, It's more traditional and costumes are very, very colorful. So I would suggest Pushkar is like a color avenue. Like you need to shoot Pushkar in color. But you know what happens when you are shooting Pushkar in color, and then you find something amazing happening late evening where, you know, the light is like not that great, but then the mood is there and no bright pagadi or mustaches or skin you are showing, then maybe sometimes the black and white also works very good. So you can see this image. Now this image is very, very simplified, but extreme wide angle have been used. So for me, you know, I do all styles of photography and very versatile themes also. So black and white works for me in every theme also. It's not only street and portrait where I do only black and white. Wherever I find black and white interesting, so I just convert it into a black and white later when I do editing. So always do the black and white processing later when you edit your pictures, right? So I want to show you my camera. Like, this is an electronic viewfinder camera, okay? And the good thing about these cameras are when you are shooting on a black and white mode, right? So your viewfinder and screen also become black and white. Can you see this? So the beauty is you can analyze your pictures on the spot when you are taking pictures. So when you are seeing through the viewfinder, you will realize, okay, this black is what I require, is this very good, and you know the white is also working or the light is playing that role. So all these electronic viewfinder cameras are giving us a very, very important perspective through the viewfinder. Because if you see in DSLR cameras, when you see from the viewfinder, it is always an optical viewfinder and it's always in color because you see in color. So then you see the pictures later on your screen and visualize how monochromatic stuff is looking on the screen. Then you notice, okay, this is working or this is not working. So these cameras are helping us to shoot black and white. So we can see on the spot what is happening, especially in raw file, right? So again, one of the picture from streets of Old Delhi. So if you notice on the left hand side top and on the top of the frame, you will see a lot of boards of shops, like Bata is on the left, and you know all these boards are adding colors to these pictures, and you know they are like distracting shots. So one is some shots where there are no colors, we need a black and white. But when there are too many colors, busy colors, like they are distracting, they are conflicting with your main elements, shadows, then it's time to go for a monochromatic. Like you need to do a black and white there. So very, very simple shot, but light is coming from back. So you can feel those lines and shape and shadows and play of light. And then the busy street of Old Delhi can always seen in the picture. So you need a black and white. So this is how your heart, you know, photographers already believe that, you know, all legendary photographers, that we make our pictures not with the cameras, we make our pictures with our soul and mind and heart. So this is one coming up for you. So again, Yamuna River is like overshot place in our Delhi, and it is one of our landmark when it comes to photographers, travelers, right? So you can see this image. It was taken when people were not visiting Yamuna and it was not that important for tourists and Instagrammers. And these ghats are not existing anymore because these were carried away by the floods a long time back. Again, this shot was like 13, 15 years back, taken on a digital camera, right? 6.1 megapixel. And then this mood, you know, when there is no sky color like blue or clouds, it's like a flat situation, whites. So then it's time to, you know, cultivate that spirit of black and white in your pictures. So again, see these seagulls around, and those structures and lines are working also in this black and white effect. And this is again one of my personal favorite and very, very popular picture, also published in one of my catalog, you can see. So the satisfaction you get is when you are published, right? So you are showcasing on Instagram, or you are showcasing stuff on your Facebook, it's okay, but then you need to print. So see another one, which is very, very documentary style, where it's on the Dhobi Ghat in Delhi. And so again, shot on, this was shot on a film camera, so the film would have a unique texture to the images, and it works very good when we see it after the print has been done. After the production, you can feel those textures, and you know, you can feel those minute details, so they look very, very impressive. So or maybe you will find you very, very simple style of images, where you see that, you know, there are not much color, or the red fort is distracting, right? So the red color is distracting. So now it's again time for a black and white. So you need to decide, okay, I need, the sky is not working, sky is not doing anything, it's just a white. Then I need a black and grays in my pictures. So I need to find out those. So this is how we select, you know, how to deal with these kind of pictures when we are shooting, right? Or just see this picture coming up, which is like in a Kerala fisherman's coast, where it's all dramatic, you know, dark boats and then clouds, all in the hues of grays. So you know that, you know, it's not a sunset or a sunrise image. It's more a documentary style, journalistic approach to it. So it's time for a black and white, you know. So, but you need to take inspirations when you shoot black and white. You know, you need to see work of Henri Cartier-Bresson. Largely, he has done all his street photography in black and white. And then, if you see Ansel Adams' landscapes, you will be amazed to see those black and white landscapes he did on a bigger camera, plate camera. It was so difficult to shoot in those eras, but they have done wonderful jobs during you know, those film eras. And then the inspiration is always at home. I have catalogs of legendary S. Paul and you know, my guru, and I keep on visualizing these pictures to get that mood of black and white. You know, how the man did the black and white fine art images, because people know black and white as a fine art medium. And this was done by S. Paul, and a very, very unique picture of a veil of Indian woman. And you know, so these books always give me energy to shoot it black and white. So this is one of his famous picture of Red Fort. And now this place is you can't dry your clothes or even go inside because of the World Heritage norms, because Red Fort is now a World Heritage UNESCO monument. So you have those inspirations at home. So when I see these kind of pictures, which are already taken by the master photographer S. Paul, so now you need to, you know, grow up and think on his lines, and you know, you need to develop your vision, how the man you know, did those black and white stuff. Right, so these are all my inspiration on black and whites. So you need to, and see the old man image, very, very popular fine art style portrait of his, is again, these were published by prints. So like you make a negative, the black and white, and then you process them into the print. And then these were reproduction done on his German catalog, the exhibition catalog, right? So this is how I got inspirations on shooting black and white. You know, what subject to be taken? Like, see, very, very popular and famous picture of his a migrant worker and taking his sheeps along, and right, so this is how we need inspiration. Everyone needs inspiration. So this is the agenda of taking this lecture, is like, you know, we need to discuss how to do black and white, or how to think on black and white when we do processing, because we have a picture already taken and now it's in our hard disks. Now we are just seeing those pictures and then analyzing whether to go with color or black and white. So see the other picture, and I will take you one color and black and white as well. So this is again a famous picture where you have a Kumbh Mela, and then you have Sylhet style early morning shot. So you know that, you know, you need just black and white to get that flavor. No color should be there and no distraction should be there in those images. So, you know, that works very good for all of us. So now take example of this picture of Sadhu. For me, you know, when I go and visualize my subject on the street, so I always think in my mind that this picture need to be color, because those marigold flowers will look jazzy, fresh, glowing, right? So Naga pictures sometimes look very good in black and white, because, you know, you get those textures, the lines, the faces, the ash on the skin. But for this very picture, if you see, now you need to do it in color. No point doing black and white. So that way you need to think like, you know, this picture demands black and white, or this picture don't demand black and white. So that is important, right? So comment I am turning off, then I'll open up again. Alright, so let me see how the pictures are looking with the bigger screen, right? So now silhouettes, semi-silhouettes, and then shadows on the wall, reflections, they actually look very good in black and white. You must have noticed that, like, these kind of pictures look amazing in black and white. Now, suppose in case of this image where the wall is little beige, little yellowish, the normal wall. So that was looking very, very distracting when I was shooting the image. But then the figures, they are talking, these are reflection. These are shadows. So the shadows were looking like talking shadows to me. So then you need to decide, I need this in black and white, or this is a subject of a black and white, right? So here we do black and white, and the hand, the silhouettes, those are very important to capture in silhouettes, because silhouettes are a mood style of black and white images where the face is not showing, but you can make out from the body language that, you know, what they are talking or their expressions, right? Or see something like this, a shot with no gray tones at all. Because deliberately the contrast was made like that later, so that you don't see a gray tone in the image. So purpose is, like, when you don't see gray tone, so you will see high contrast black and white images. So you will see black and you will see just the white. So sky, red fort, exterior, and lot of pigeons all around is making a story here. Yeah. So can we open the comments, and I'll take up some. Can you just please turn off the comment? Okay. So last 15 minutes we'll dedicate to your queries. So okay, I'm doing the caption, like, comments off right now, so that you will have more mood to the pictures. I hope you are liking the collection. So when we talk about, like, black and white, So I should also look in black and white, right? So I will use my profile also black and white today. And I will take this shot, like, I'm shooting and then I'm shooting in black and white. So the color is very distracting. See, So black and white is looking so pretty. So this is why black and white is satisfying your heart as the artist. So now one series which is very close to my heart, because I do animal photography as well, wildlife and you know, animal on the streets as well. So see, this is a simple shot of an elephant, and just the tightly cropped taken in Jim Corbett long time back. And I realized that I need to show elephant in black and white, so that, you know, the distraction of this brown log should be eliminated. And the if you see, the picture is very, very cross section of elephant, you know, leg, and deliberately it's a tight shot. It's not cropped. It's taken as it is. So as a photographer, you need to think like, I need this shot, right? So I'll make the light was so pretty. You can see those side light falling, and the texture is amazing, right? So I hope you all can see those textures. So black and white is so appealing, right? So again, this is a shot where you know, it's like again a reflection of a line, and then black and white was so amazing because the green was distracting. Green was not making that sense. So by making it monochromatic, you will feel same here. So the picture is just a pure subject of monochromatic, and only you can feel those dual colors here. Black and white are prominent with gray tones, and it's like overpowering the composition just because of that beauty. And we say that, you know, in compositions we say that overlapping is not acceptable, and of course that is true in most of the imagery. But at times when we are shooting something like offbeat pictures, and you do overlapping. So I made it a point to take this from a viewpoint where I see just the merge of the two animals. So two zebras are like merging with each other and making a very, very different wildlife image. So imagine this picture in color, where everything is green. So you will see that, you know, the punch is missing. So in this, you will find amazing, you know, color quality, like the monochromatic feel is there. The contrast is there. You can feel the contrast. So this is how we need to do certain images in this manner, or something like this, a simple picture of architecture with the birds. And again, now no gray tones in this. So all tones are just white and black. The technique goes, just open up the contrast of your image till you achieve stark contrast, like black and white. So when you see that elimination is going on and gray tone is missing now in the pictures, and pictures are looking appealing, then you stop there. But they work specially in silhouette style photography, where the light is from behind the subject. It's not like light is falling on the subject and you need to do this type of effect. It's not possible, right? So something design, like, you know, some design element in the image. It's lattice, and then you are seeing something, visualizing through the window, through the lattice work. And black and white gives that wonderful appeal to the images, right? Or something like just arches, and you don't need to throw attention on any other color than all those blacks and grays. So again, this is important to portray in black and white. Now imagine we go to a subject which is a Holi festival in Barsana, Nandgaon, and you are thinking that, you know, I'll do only black and white. So maybe I think it's a wrong decision, because Holi is full of colors, and you need to, you know, portray those colors of Holi in your pictures. You can't just do a black and white there, unless it's like a portrait or something which is relevant to monochromatic. So take this example, right? Two pictures. So it's like Holi. So it's meant to be colorful, right? Like Holi is meant to be full of colors. So if you think that, you know, will make it a black and white, so for me it will never work. So I need to know your opinion on Holi pictures. I'm opening the comment. Please feel free to comment on this, how you think on this. We need to go with color. All believe that we need to go with color. Just I'm waiting for your comments, right? Color. Yeah. So Holi is a color, right? So, and then this picture is beauty. Beauty is in color here. So no point making it in black and white, right? So now when we are on street and we are shooting people and subjects. So this is one of my shot from Varanasi, and you know, when I was shooting, so I realized that, you know, this man is like typical black and white subject, and my props in the back is all also blacks, right? So buffaloes were black and the sky was just white because it's a backlit, little bit of light is coming from the top left. And you need to realize this is, I need it in black and white, they will look very pretty. So I was like composing my shot, and you know, this guy was looking very, very energetic to see my camera. Then he was unaware the fact that I was composing the two, one body and one head at his back also, you know. So I was just making myself comfortable for the composition, you know, where to keep the buffalo head. So, and this shot was made, and black and white was the call. So essentially some pictures need to be in black and white. So graphic images where, you know, you can see those graphic style images, right? And so in the image, it's like outside the Makkah Masjid in Hyderabad, and the ladies were sitting in burqas and black, wearing black, and then the half of the masjid was also composed. So you need to know that, you know, these are the black and white choice pictures, or something like this, the Yamuna Delhi early morning shot of bathing and spiritual dips, holy dips. So you need to do black and white to get that feel. One of the picture of old Delhi, where deliberately low angle was taken. I was using a 1635 super wide, the G Master, and the camera was just on the floor, and I waited the man to, you know, fill my composition. And then again, the situation is like both sides, a lot of shops around with distracting colors. So, but then your main subject is so powerful in the foreground. So black and white is the call, the fantastic approach where black and white is the call. So it's a Swachh Bharat image where, you know, they are cleaning up the Agra Fort, and light is like coming from the back. So I love shooting black and white stuff in against the light. You know, that quality of light is the punch in the pictures. And they get those dramatic light and texture in the images. So this is from that. And you need to always see that, you know, this picture need a vertical shot, or this is or horizontal, or take both. Because I've seen people like they are just shooting horizontal, but they don't realize the beauty of long shot, which are also important. So very important to get those. You need to think like, you know, I need a vertical or a horizontal shot on the spot. So now the next picture is like essentially picture need to be in color. So So the picture, sometime you need to do this picture in color, because otherwise it will look boring. See, the picture in black and white is just dull looking because the colors are missing now in the shot. But when you see the picture in color, so it's vibrant. It's colors of our country, the customs, the traditions. So those look so pretty in color, right? So can we see a couple of the comments? So I think everybody is going with my selection, like where I like color and, you know, and then where to do black and white. So everyone agrees on that. So great, 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 great. Now, I when I go out with my camera and I'm shooting people and then I'm shooting street and I see trees around, right? So I will not stop myself. I don't feel that, you know, I'm a street photographer, so I will not be taking trees. It's more of a nature photography. So for me, every genre works. Every field, you know, excites me as a photographer, right? So see this one. So the beauty here is like light and shade, and you know, they look so connecting with the life. When you see the picture, it's like networking of trees all around, and the Akbar tomb looking through the tree, right? So when you come back and you see those greens are distracting, and then a little bit of sky is like blue and then white, it's not working. But the picture need that, you know, punch and that high contrast style. So then you make it a black and white, and you will feel that, yeah, it works. So one assignment for everyone, because in every talk when I do, I will throw one assignment where you need to hashtag that theme on my account. On your, you just post it on your feed and hashtag me, and whatever I like out of those submission, I will feature it on my Insta story. So now you can hashtag black and white and hashtag Dheeraj Paul. So whatever I like, I will put it on my Insta story, right? So, and be innovative. Just see your stock, because I know it's a lockdown. You can't go out and take a fresh shot, but then your existing pictures, sit on the computer, open them, analyze whether they look good in black and white, convert it into black and white, and then see. So I would recommend you not to go to that tool where you turn it into a grayscale, okay? You need to treat your color pictures in RGB and then do a black and white, so that you will retain those RGB adjustment to your images. Because many places you need to give little bit of tint of red to get those contrast in the images, right? Or maybe when you are shooting green trees and you need to make them lighter, you need to give a yellow green filter to this. Earlier times we were shooting black and white films and we were using those color filters over our lenses. So those were just to give those gradation better in your monochromatic stuff, right? So never do a grayscale, just make it a black and white, but keep RGB intact so that you can color correct your pictures. So again, typical pictures, this is from Mumbai, and you know, the pot making is in process. So you know that, you know, this picture is like very, very art style, and color will not do justice. It's like all shades of grays, so they work, all right? or something like this. It's you are shooting a graphic style of images where the boat, water, sky, backlit, mixed lighting situations, and seagulls are white. So you know that, you know, we can try this. This scene looks good in color as well, but then it depends on the light. When we are shooting early morning and you know the sky is behind our subject and it's like yellow glow is coming in the images, then of course it is very, very appealing. But when it's the overcast style of a morning and you will find lesser hues of yellows and warm colors, so then it's time to go for black and white there. So it's whenever I see those blacks and navy blues in my pictures and you know, and no sky contributing in the images, so I need to go it in black and white. I will always do a black and white there, right? So or something like the fog. The Delhi winters are amazing. You know, we get lot of fog end of December and January. It's like many times Delhi is just covered with fog, and people find it difficult to shoot pictures that time, and they keep at home and stay at home, and you know. But then when we go out early morning, I know it's like about 4-5 degrees normally in Delhi, and but then amazing shots you get of fog, and they look so pretty in black and white. So only catch is you need to have a foreground to your fog images. If your fog images is only showing you fog and there is no subject in the center, around, in the foreground to hold the viewer's eye, then you miss the shot, right? So you need to have like these 2-3 people are talking each other and planning for their day, and the boat is diagonally placed and two boats are in the background, and then tree, branch of the tree, and then fog. So they look good. Take example of these two pictures. So now in the picture above, now you will see the fisherman red orange t-shirt is like making our attention there. So see these two pictures. So attention of the viewer is going on the red t-shirt, but when you treat it as a black and white, you will find all the distraction vanishes and the attention is more on the blacks, which is required. So now see these two pictures, black and white and color. So what was happening is the color in color picture, it was blue coming somewhere or some green showing in. But then after you decide that I need to do it in black and white, and now see, you know that your subjects are all in blacks majorly. So by doing a black and white here, now the street shot is getting the attention. In color, it's not getting the attention. See, it's not getting the attention because a lot of green, blues in the picture below, you will see a lot of colors are distracting. So when you go for a black and white here, now your eye is just focusing on what is interesting. The dog and the lady in veil, she's buying, planning to buy fish in the morning, and this is from the Kochi fishing spot, so very, very important place, right? So backlit silhouettes with people, they are amazing. They look beautiful in black and white. So this is a shot from Varanasi Ghat early morning, and then clean shot, and your subject, the element, is in the foreground, and the boats at the back not clashing with your foreground, and separation is done while taking, and horizon space on the top, is nothing was on the top, so it was taken in a smaller way, and more space given to the picture below. So now before the next image is coming, this is again very important picture to me, because you know, one, I love trees, then I like architecture photography, and I love fog, winter. So North India winter is just amazing. So just see this image, and people are going there and trying to, you know, copy that idea with different elements here from long time now. And of course this place is amazing. Everyone goes there, gets a different output altogether. So the picture is the Taj Mahal, and it's the symbol of love, and I am loving this picture, and I hope you will also love it. So a very simple picture of tree, and it's a early morning semi-silhouette style image, and then it's a foggy morning. Picture was taken with 70-300 zoom lens, right? This I still remember, the camera was a Sony Alpha 7R M2. So it was a earlier model camera, and the picture was also taken about 2015-2016 time. And it's from the Mehtag Bagh, and we were at the far and seeing the amazing light of the morning, which was like just fog, and the focus was done on the tree, because the beauty of tree against the charming Taj Mahal, right? So this was the concept of taking this picture. It's not like you are taking a Taj picture, it's like you are taking the picture of the tree. Yeah, because you like those trees and you love those trees, right? So this was done. So we'll go to the next one, and then we'll take up your queries also. So this is a very spontaneous shot taken of Diwan-e-Aam in Red Fort, Delhi. And I still remember I was carrying a small Sony RX100 camera with me. It's a 1-inch sensor camera, very compact pocket style camera. And I just went inside the Red Fort, and I found that, you know, this they have put in one glass here to prevent those marble and carvings of the Red Fort, because you know a lot of people just keep touching those designs and spoiling the beauty of our old heritage. So when I saw like reflections on the glass and people behind me standing looking at the Diwan-e-Aam, and I found that this could be an interesting architecture with people shot. And I did this one, see it again. So this was just centered myself in the arch, and then again only the color was the red sandstone color of and a little bit of marble white and beige was there. So again black and white gave it a punch to hold the image, or something like this, taken from a corner with a super wide angle lens, 1635 on my Sony mirrorless, and this was in Bhutan. So again, so black and white gave it a dramatic architecture style image. So I told you, like, I do architecture, I do street, so the 2-3 cameras always with me, and when I'm moving, I'm seeing everything. So it's like a blessing in your vision, that you know you can identify your images even when you are shooting portrait and you see architecture there. You are shooting architecture and you see people also there. So I do that very often. So this was in Kerala, very simple shot with a crow on the top. So, you know, some shots need to be in black and white. So you need to have a black and white. Again, one of the shot from Red Fort, and these jharokas are so beautiful, and Islamic architecture gives you that advantage to shoot these with your camera. But only thing is, you need to be like very, very you need to place the lens in the center of your architecture so that you know you see a mirror image style, and the distortion is should be very, very minimal when you are shooting these kind of stuff. And then people on the street or silhouettes in Pushkar, they work very good. It's again a very, very people like this picture very much. It's again a fog and the beauty of Himayu Tomb, the hidden beauty, morning shot of Delhi. And the yoga was not that popular that time, so for me it's like it's early morning yoga at Himayu's tomb, and you know he's enjoying the yoga. Or imagine this picture in color. So Jantar Mantar inside is all orangish red painted. So if you get those colors, so you will lose the power of that image. So this picture looks so appealing and powerful because of monochromatic style, right? So this was a shot taken with 14 millimeter fixed lens and 14 millimeter 2.8 lens used on a full frame camera, and you will see the perspective is also like huge. And I was just lying down and the lens was facing the sky, and the pigeons were like moving, and I was just waiting for the right action there with a 500 shutter speed on my camera. And I waited for this shot not like for very long, but then 15-20 minutes of patience given with this shot. And you know, sometimes you are very lucky, you are shooting, you are waiting, and you wait very less and you get the shot. Sometimes you need to wait for hours and then also you don't get that shot. So it depends. If you are lucky, then you are lucky, right? So now this shot, if you see, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4 windows, different sizes and different views. And this is Agrasen Ki Bauli in New Delhi, Connaught Place region, a very, very popular landmark for travelers and young people. So see this in black and white. A lens is 1635 super wide, so I was making myself straight to this structure, and it's a vertical shot. I love taking verticals as well, and see the shot. Now you will have all four windows, and the character of the windows are different. In this situation, always remember, we need to give the exposure of the brightest light. We don't need any light falling on the inner side of the wall. So it is important. So you give the exposure to the sky and the brighter side, you get that effect, right? So you get those. Kutub is very famous, another World Heritage Monument from Delhi. We have three here: Himayu's Tomb, Red Fort and Kutub. And all three are wonderful for photographers. So people, long shadows, Kutub, side light. It's like a black and white feel, early morning shot. It's all like Pushkar morning, daily life. So no color, you know, early morning, the daughter and the father and people around, the life is going on. So there was no color. So, but then the black and white gives that feel. So black and white is always so beautiful when you need to show the character of the face, the emotions. So people say that, you know, if you want to show clothes, you shoot in color. If you want to show emotion, you shoot in black and white. So of course, emotions are very, very well presented on this monochromatic medium. And and see, the other one is like, the short is full of spirituality and motion, and it's like attention to detail short, right? So just have a look. Right, so the appeal is just like people outside Brahma temple in Pushkar, and you know, I saw these hand formation was amazing, like the fingers showing and nails. And so then I composed just a tight shot without showing the face, no head. So for me, like, this is again a portrait style photography where emotions are there but no face. So some dramatic location need to be in black and white. You don't have any choices. This is one of the night shot taken with the very fast wide angle lens, 28 1.8, and no light. There was no light on the ghat of Allahabad. This was taken during 2013 Kumbh, Mahakumbh. And like, the priest was wearing these saffron, but color was just nil in the picture. So, and it was a very, very dark situation. Even this one was a dark situation, the same like the another composition of this. This was also taken there. So I was working on a bokeh in black and white, so how they look. So because of this 1.8 aperture lens, 28 millimeter, I was getting the wide angle as well, I was getting the bokehs. So I found that, you know, the orange color was too busy. So I put it on a black and white there. So guys, I hope you are enjoying these pictures, and please, for any query, you can write down on my Insta message. And of course, we need to catch up again on some different theme altogether. So I do Insta Live about 7-10 days in 7 to 10 days. And we will do a very, very structured one on a theme. You have already seen this picture. And this picture is like, so is love for nature, right? So spotted deer, Bharatpur, and then trees, you know, the whole frame is with trees. So from corner to corner, you will feel the amazing branches, the trees, right? And one thing you don't need to miss, that you need to send me the images, and we will be featuring you. And when you are at home, you can also take something like these at home, or just take still life images. They look so good in black and white, right? So it's you that decided where to use black and white. You know, it's the artist, it's the photographer, right? There are no rules that why we should do a color or a black and white. So thank you very much for joining me, and I look forward for your images, interesting images. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye.